Greetings in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It's a blessing to be in your midst today. Today is a good day. I thank God for the opportunity to come again in this ministry. This morning, the message will be entitled, Dig Again the Wells of Your Father. Hallelujah. Could we just reverence God? Father, I thank you for your word. You said that your word is forever settled in heaven. Father, whatsoever is done today, I pray, Lord God, that it will bring relief to those who are bound. Father, that it will bring deliverance. Father, that it will touch some heart today in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Today the reading is from the book of Genesis, chapter 26, and I'm going to read verse 19, praise God. And Isaac's servants dug in the valley and found there a well of spring water. Praise God. Hallelujah. I've realized that water is a very important thing in our island, Tobago. At times, the authority will complain and tell you it's time to conserve water. It's time to save the water. But today I want to share about farming and the real importance of water, not only in a physical sense, but also in a spiritual sense. The Bible tells us that Isaac, he was a good listener. In fact, he followed his father's steps so closely that he understood what it meant to dig wells. In fact, Abraham, the Bible says he grew in strength and he grew in wealth. He grew in cattle and sheep and all these livestock. And the thing about livestock is that livestock always needs water. In order to keep your livestock, you need water. So the Bible tells us that Abraham had dug some wells. And because of the land he was in, which was the land of the Philistines, he was there and they saw that he was increasing in strength. He was increasing in wealth. And they thought that, hey, the only way this man could increase is if he has water. So the Bible tells us that they began on a mission to cut down the man of God. The Bible tells us that every well that Abraham dug in the time of Isaac, that the Philistines filled their wells. They filled those wells with earth. At times you may feel that, hey, all the wells that I've been digging over the years, it seems like they have been stopped up. It might not be stopped up with earth, but seems sometimes like somebody else had come in and filled your well. You see, I've learned that good things comes by digging. If you want diamond, you have to dig for it. If you want gold, you need to dig for it. If you need oil, as Trinidad and Tobago's economy is based on, you need to dig. Therefore, you need to dig deep sometimes in order to achieve the goals that you are heading for. In our country today, there are times that it seems like the oil prices just will not come up enough for us to prosper. But I'm here to tell you, so as it is in the physical, there it is in the spiritual realm. At times we realize that the crime in our country, it's not getting better. We realize that things in our nation just does not add up to what the Word of God says. My advice today is, it's time to open back up the wells. You see, the well of prayer has been stopped up in many places. The well of fasting has been stopped up in many places. But I'm here to let you know, it's time to open back up the wells. God has so planned and designed it that, hey, the well of the physical well brings forth water. In a time of famine, the thing that we need most is water. I've observed and I've realized that if you have no water, you have no plants. If you have no plants, the animals can't eat. Therefore, you have no animals, and famine is a bad thing. Therefore, in the spirit realm, if you don't dig deep your well into God's reservoir, you may end up in a spiritual famine. This famine, in fact, in the Bible tells us that there will come a time when there will be a famine. And this famine is not for water. This famine will not be for bread. But this famine will be a famine for the word of God. I've realized that there is a lot of people preaching today, but they are not preaching what the word of God is saying. And many of people have been carried away with every wind. But I'm here to tell you, it's time to dig deep. Go back to the foundation. Go back to the wells that your father had dug years ago. The foundation with which we stood on as young men and young women. The wells we went to as young men and young women. I remember the time of prayer and fasting. I remember the times of seeking God. When a nation needs a well, a spring to go to, the church must be such a place. The Bible tells us that Abraham had dug some wells. And the thing about it, when Isaac came on the scene and became old enough, and Abraham had since died, the Bible says that the Philistines, they were so vexed with him because of his prosperity that they start filling up the wells. But the thing about Isaac is that he remembered the wells that his father dug. He remembered that his father dug some wells. And every time he go back and found a well that his father dug, and he digged it up again. You see, at times we have to go back and dig it up again. Never give up. Never stop searching, because Isaac could have said, hey, I'm here and I'm prospering, but my friends, my neighbors don't want to see me prosper, so they dig up and they bury your wells. Isaac could have had a pity party because he was in the place to have a pity party. But the Bible says that he went and he dug again a new well. The Bible also says that when the Philistines saw this, that they strove with him again for that new well. Like you today, every time it seems that you are going ahead, every time it seems like you are going to prosper, it seems like somebody is coming and throwing dirt in your well. But Isaac didn't stay there. Isaac didn't stop. In fact, what Isaac did, he moved again and he went to a valley. And the Bible tells us that in that valley, he dug and he found a fresh stream. It's today the day that you need to dig deep. Go and look again. Some of us are giving up too easy. Sometimes we seek God, and because the answer doesn't come right away, we give up. But I'm here to let you know, it's time to dig again. It's time to look again. It's time to seek again. Reopen the wells. And talking about again, I remember Elisha. And this story, it to me, it's a story that took my mind into the frame of, hey, high famine. The Bible tells us in the book of Kings that Elijah called a famine. And because the king was doing wickedly, Elijah said, from today there will be no rain. Imagine the man of God proclaiming a famine. And after this proclamation by the man of God, the Bible says that God spoke to the man of God. And the man of God was told to go by a brook. You see, what I'm trying to say is that in the time of famine, where you may seem that your spiritual food is dried up, God had supply a way. God will supply a means for you today. Elijah was by the brook. And the Bible tells us by that brook, God fed him. You see, sometimes it takes some things that we don't think about, but God can use anything and anyone. The Bible tells us that a raven came at morning, in the morning time, and fed Elijah bread and meat. You see, in famine, there are things that are not readily available. In your time of famine, you may say, getting to prayer and fast today might not be readily available. But what I'm here to let you know is God will supply the way. God will supply the means. And Elijah found out that God does what he said he will do. Imagine Elijah by this brook. And a raven, in fact, we may say in Trinidad and Tobago, a cobra came and fed him every morning. But the thing about it is this. While being fed by the brook of Cherith, the Bible tells us after a while, the brook dried up. It seems that, hey, after a while, God had spoken to you and God had given you instructions and tell you do X. But it seems now that that brook is drying up. I'm saying don't give up. Don't give in. Don't throw in the towel. All you need to do is wait for another word from God. Although the brook at Cherith dried up, that did not dry up the plan of God. That did not stop the will of God. But hear what happened to Elijah. The Bible said the word of God came unto Elijah again. Go down, and there is a widow woman I have ordained to keep thee. You see, at times our deliverance will come from unexpected sources. This woman did not know that she would have been the prophet's way out of this dry place. In fact, in her mind, she only had a little meal. In her mind, she only had just a little thing to go on, maybe for the day, because she herself proclaimed, she said, I will make me a cake, I will eat it, I will give it to my son, and then I will die. Some of us sit in our zones and we think, well, this is the last straw. I'm going to just sit here and die. But the word of God came unto the prophet, and the prophet did exactly what God said to him. When he went down and met this woman, the woman, remember, the woman was not a wealthy woman. God could have sent him to a wealthy woman. God could have sent him to somebody who had plenty. But God sent him to the poorest, to the meek. God sent him, and he obeyed. This woman had a son, and she decided in her heart that this is all I have. This is all I have. But hear what? Because of thy word, I will bake you that cake first. In fact, that is what the man of God told her. Yes, I know you only have a little bit. Yes, I know that is a little oil you have. But God is in it. In fact, I hear one person says, little is much when God is in it. When you think you don't have anything at all, once you have God in it, it's much. Therefore, this woman, she went in. She went in and she baked that cake. Sir, when she finished, she brought that cake to the man of God. And you could see this man of God, and some people will say that he's greedy, he's licorice, because he ate first. But that is where the miracle lies. The miracle lies when she went back to that pot, when she went back to that flower pot, when she went back to that cruse of oil, she realized that something strange is happening. She realized that something is happening with my oil. Something is happening with my flour. Here she is, and able to sustain herself, her son, for the period of time. You see, at times, we give up a little too early. At times we give up a little too soon, because just when God is about to move, sometimes when God is just about to move, we quit on the job, we stand still, we give up, we throw in the towel. But I'm here to let you know, it's time to dig, it's time to keep on digging, it's time to strive towards what God has ordained for us. The Bible tells us that after that, God told Elijah, hey, it's time for the famine to over. It's time for things to come. You see, God is perhaps telling somebody today, you've been through your famine, you've been through your storm, you've been through whatsoever you've been going through, but now is the time to come out. You see, the Bible tells us that Elijah went to see the king. And when going there to see the king, he took his servant, and there they were having a discussion. And in the midst of the discussion, Elijah said, do you see any clouds? And at times, this is so true. When we look for answers in certain places, they are not there to be found. Sir, at noon rain comes from the sky. But when the servant looked to the sky, there was no clouds. How could God promise rain and there is no cloud? So Elijah spoke to his servant. He said, go again. And for some of us, to go again will take all that we have. Imagine this servant went again the second time, and he looked, and when he looked, he can see nothing again. Doesn't that sound like God? Sometimes we're digging our wells, and sometimes it takes long to find water. We are digging again those wells of things that God has bestowed upon us, and it seems like it's not coming through for us. But here is this man of God. God, in fact, Elijah told his servant, he said, go and don't stop until you go seven times. On the seventh time, he came back. The Bible tells us that his report was one that he seen a cloud. But it's no greater than the size of a man's hand. I'm here to let you know, sometimes you need to look. But sometimes when you see that the God is bringing it through, it doesn't have to be big. It doesn't have to be a massive cloud. But what he saw was big enough. What he saw was good enough for God to work his miracle through. You see, what I've realized is sometimes we ask for wells. We ask God to supply water. And I found out that a lot of us do not have the vessels to contain the water. A lot of us neglect to prepare our vessels to contain this overflow of water. In fact, I remember just a few days ago, I was home, and I remember standing by my vehicle, and I was just preparing to go into the house when I heard something. I heard the rains coming, just like what this servant did. And from a distance, I could hear something. And what, to all my knowledge of rain, it didn't only sound like a small shower, but it sounded like a great number, a real rush. Sir, God wants to bless you. And sir, madam, you need to prepare. Because when God is showering, when God is giving you that spring, it's not just a little spring. The Bible tells us that the rain began to fall. Sir, madam, you need to prepare for the rain, because when the rain comes from God, it's going to wash. If it's one thing God likes to do, is deal with abundance. I'm here to let you know, God is about to pour out his abundance. After you have dug your well, after you have stayed where God had placed you, the Bible says that he will abundantly, he will and can abundantly, but you need to get ready. For those of you who don't know Jesus Christ, God wants to shower upon you his abundant life. In fact, Jesus himself says, come unto me, all ye are labored and heavy laden, and I will give you. In fact, he wants to give you this abundance of life. But sir, you need to get yourself ready. By getting ready means to get out from the place you are. Some of you need to get out and go and see what God is doing. You need to get out from the situation you are in. But it only will take God and his presence to bring you out. Here you have Elijah. He's there and he prayed. In fact, that handful, God knows how to deliver. God knows how to bring that burden down. God knows how to create nothing or create something from nothing. He wants to do that to you today. If you are listening to this broadcast and you have not served Jesus before, or some of you may have started digging your well and you have stopped, what I'm saying is that you started to follow Jesus, but then you said, hey, I can't make this work anymore. I can't do it anymore. I'm here to let you know that he's able to help you. You don't have to carry your burdens alone. Jesus wants to help you. Today is a good day. Today is a good day to continue that well. For some of you, the well is a well where you need to repeat that well of prayer. You have laid it upon a shelf, put it aside. But if God is saying to you today, dig over that well. Start digging again the wells of salvation. Go and dig that well of prayer. Today is your day. Sir, madam, I'm here to encourage you today. I'm here to encourage you today to give your life to Jesus. If one thing I'm expecting from this broadcast is for you to accept Jesus into your life. I've understood that people in Tobago, most of them have been to a Sunday school, have been to a church. But I'm saying to you, it's time to dig again that well. Come back to God, ye that have gone astray. It's time to turn your life around and give God a chance in your life again. Go back and dig that well again. God wants to change your life. God wants to make you a new person. In fact, right where you are, I want to pray with you. I want to pray for you. You want to dig again that well. Regardless of all the things that has been coming your way. Just like Isaac, you need to go and dig again. Those wells which your father had laid, they are good wells. Today, if you're so desirous of turning your life to Jesus, I want to lead you in the sinner's prayer. The Bible says that he is willing that none should perish, but that all come to repentance. Today is your day. This morning is your morning. Would you say this prayer with me? Lord Jesus, I've wandered far from you, and I want to come home. Lord Jesus, please forgive me of my sins, and make me your son. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you have said that prayer, I want to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, you've seen that man, that woman, that boy or that girl who has said that prayer with me. Father, I pray, Lord God, that your salvation now become real to them, that your salvation become real to their hearts right now in Jesus' name.
If there's somebody sick in the house right now, I want to pray for you, because this same God I'm preaching about is a healing God. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, that woman on that bed right now, in the name of Jesus, I pray, Lord God, that you touch her right now, heal her right now, in the name of Jesus. Father, for those who are listening this tape, Father, and they have that concern, Lord God, right now, that woman with the heart problem, Father, I break that spell, I break that curse right now, in Jesus' name, be free, in Jesus' name. God richly bless you. Until another time, I'm Brother Curtis Collins, and I'm glad to be in your presence to share with you the Word of God. Praise God.
This program comes to you compliments of the Tobago Inspirational Network. To support this and other programs, we encourage you to give to TIN. Contributions can be made at any First Citizens Bank at account number 203-4679. We thank you for your support.